Hello friends, welcome to my channel and explore the world of Microsoft Azure. My name is Rajneesh Kaushik and I'm a Microsoft certified trainer, consultant and an enterprise architect. For more latest videos and blogs, you can always log into my website rajneeshkaushik.com and subscribe to my blog. Please do not forget to subscribe my channel and click the bell icon so you don't miss the latest videos. Do like, share and comment.
Today we will learn about how do we integrate Azure Container Registry with Azure Kubernetes Services. The agenda for this is to understand these integrations and then followed by a demo. So first we will create a Azure Container Registry, then we will create a Azure Kubernetes Services, and we will showcase this demo by building a an image into the Azure Container Registry, and then we will deploy the same image into the Azure Kubernetes Services with the help of a deployment services or deployment YAML file. So this demo contains these steps. First, we will create an AKS and ACR instance with the help of Azure CLI. Then we will see the different integration settings between ACR and AKS. Then once this integration is done, then we will import an image, NGINX image from Docker Hub into the ACR instance. Then we will create an AKS deployment file. And finally, we will apply this deployment file to the AKS and verify the deployment. So let's get started. So let's understand this code. So first, we are going to use the Azure CLI. We are using Visual Studio code, and we are using AZ CLI extension. So first we will log into the Azure CLI with AZ login. Then we will create these three variables. First variable is ACR name, that means container registry name. And we are parameterizing it so that if you want to change anything, you can change it one place and it is replicating to all the commands. Then we will also do RG name, that means resource group name, and the AKS cluster name. So then with this, we will create an ACR instance first. In ACR instance, we will create with this ACR create command, and then we will create an AKS cluster. So there are three options when you can integrate ACR with AKS. So first option is that if you are creating a brand new AKS cluster, then in that time you can put the attach ACR flag here with the ACR name. So whenever this AKS cluster is getting created, it will attach this ACR with this AKS cluster. So that is point number one, the first option. Now there is another option where if suppose your ACR and AKS are in two different subscriptions, then there is no direct connectivity between them. So in order to establish that linkage, you need to put the resource ID for the resource ID for the ACR. So here in the resource ID, you will just replace this particular value, container registry name. So container registry name will you put here, and then you will put a resource ID. So with the resource ID, automatically the integration will start happening between the different subscriptions. Then there is a third option, and in that option, suppose you have created ACR at certain different time and then AKS in a different time, and you did not thought about integration between these two instances, then you can use AZ AKS update with the same attach ACR flag, and this attach ACR you need to provide the ACR name. So this is a third option. So now once you completed this integration, then what you will do, you will get the NGINX latest tag image with the NGINX image from Docker Hub. Docker Hub is nothing but docker.io, and then you will import this image into the registry. So this is the image name and you are going to import it into this ACR. Okay, that is Azure Container Registry. And then after you imported it, then now you already have the imported image. What you will do, you will get a credential of the AKS cluster which you created previously with AZ AKS command. And then Once you have the credentials, you will apply the deployment file. So let's see how your deployment file looks like. Okay. So this is your deployment file, how it looks like. And it is very, very simple file. In any deployment file format from Kubernetes, you can take that. You have to specify the replica. You have to specify the name of the label name. And this is most important. This particular image you need to specify. So this image is the it is for the first part of it is the ACR name, and this is a standard. You don't have to change it because it, Azure ACR is represented by Azure CR.io, and then this is a name of the image which is hosted in that ACR, and then you need to put the container port. Okay, so once you have this file, how will you apply this file with the CLI? Very, very important. You will come here in the Azure CLI. So you will open this Azure CLI by clicking this option. Then you will come here and upload the document file, upload or download the file. So if you come here, there is an upload option. Once you click upload option, it will provide you the dialog box. You will put that file and then upload it there. Once you upload this file, then you will come back again here and then apply this kubectl command for applying the deployment. So once you do all that, let me show you how your deployment will look like. So after doing this, your deployment is here, nginx 0 deployment. And if you see, the name of the deployment is exactly same, nginx 0 deployment. The deployment name is this. So it is getting deployed already, and it is from ACR you are able to successfully deploy it. If you see, the resource group name is AKS demo, which we created, and then again there is a registry name YACR07. This is registry, it is also created with the CLI I just shown you, and then same AKS demo is also created. And in AKS demo, if you see the replicas, let me show you that. Now here is this, and you see these are the two replicas which you have chosen here in the file, two replicas. So with this, we were able to integrate the ACR with AKS and successfully deploy the image into the AKS. And the same image is also visible in the repository section, because this is the image which was pulled from this registry and then post it to the AKS.
Thanks for watching, and do not forget to subscribe.